Time to pour one out to the blackest sea. Believe me, I heard it. After about round three or four was all he would talk about. And he's got a voice that carries. Look, nothing more I'd love than to help out a fellow Martian. Especially one that's missing. But...
He has a tab, and you don't know if he's coming back.
It's a lot of credits, okay? I let it slide for a long time because he's a regular, but... If I'm out all that money, I got problems. What do you say? Let me confirm you now. Okay. Let's talk. Last time he was here, Moera kept yelling about the Lady of Love. Singing songs. All that kind of thing.
Venus? That's only one planet. Hardly an entire patrol route.
I got what I got, okay?
Fine. We'll make do.
Most visitors can't wait to get off this rock.
I've got more than enough work to complete.
I know you were counting on that Sidonia hasn't paid.
Found a clutch of heat leeches, reading in the utility section.
I thought it was just a couple of nests.
Caution. Subterranean vertical detonation imminent. Be advised to secure this article and find the weapon or the meat.
Back on board.
Setting down. Everything in the green.
Fine by me. You mean, apart from being the chair of Constellation for the past 5 years? Well, let's see. I pride myself with my aptitude for astrodynamics, calculating optimal trajectories for grav jumping. That's been quite useful in the past. And as far as planetary exploration, my area of expertise is botany. So, don't worry. I won't let you eat anything that might put you in the hospital. Exploration is my entire life. I consider it both a career and recreation. That being said, I will make a confession, but you have to promise to keep it between us. Before I graduated from school, I was in a band. And no, I don't mean the school band. I mean a rock band. We called ourselves Ironic Comet. A ridiculous name, I know. But we were just a bunch of teenagers getting together and having fun. And before you ask, no, I wasn't the lead singer. I actually played the drums. The band never really went anywhere, of course, but those were good times, and I remember them fondly. My parents considered themselves to be enlightened, but their lives were so busy they rarely pursued their beliefs. By the time I was old enough to start questioning these things, the idea of following any organized religion was almost an afterthought. It's not that I don't want to believe in anything, it's that my scientific mind is often at odds with my spiritual center. Having been out there, in the starfield, seeing all those magnificent wonders with my own eyes, I need answers, not religious theory. I'm sorry if that disappoints you, but don't worry. While we're on this journey together, I fully intend to respect your religious beliefs. Certainly. I always enjoy our little chats. Bye. Sea pressure normal, everything in the green. Let's see what's out here.
Ready to land.
Another dead rock. Well, at least we can scour the place for materials.
Please allow me to work. I am not as fragile as you are. Is it true? Are there other Model A's?
Not exactly the surface of Mercury, but this certainly is hot. Our next stop is the moon. The one orbiting Earth, that is. Talk to you later.
Nah, I don't handle them. Hey.
You should think about...
Did you bring us something nice from a big city?
When I was younger, I thought I would love it out here. And you know, I do.
Yes? You visit other colonies? Are there any? We've lost people out here, but they want us to stay. We all believe in this place.
Yes? What?
My partner thinks spacers will want to rob this place. I'd like to see them try.
Pattern matched. Hello, visitor.
me know if you're hungry. Saw your ship. Are you looking for repairs? I don't think there's anything to fix. I'll be honest, your ship looks better than ours. Take all the time you need. Different reasons. Most of us came here from large cities originally. Some colonists are scientists. Even we take research contracts from clients who don't want to build out here themselves. It's not easy. There's no security this far out. And if any equipment breaks, that could be the end. But spend a few nights on a planet by yourself, and maybe you'll know why we're here. Yes, we do hear from them occasionally. Some colonists are List members. That's the League of Independent Settlers. It's how we stay in touch. None of us would tell another colony how to run its business, but we'll donate equipment and supplies if another List group is in trouble. Personally, not at all. We get visitors like yourself every few weeks. Everyone needs the same fuel. It keeps us fed, and we stay informed enough to remember why we like it out here. We're not hiring, if that's what you mean. But if you're looking for work, take a look at our mission board. There are always contracts for a ship and a crew. Back to civilization, huh?
Oof, you walk around in that? Find my associate, they can help.
Sometimes other colonies will send us supplies.
Okay. Hello.
I'm thinking of building a bigger hab.
Can you imagine growing up out here? Perfect.
Maybe I just want a bigger room. We're having a sale this month.
I think?
Yeah, I don't sell the merchandise. Find my partner.
Hello, stranger. Things out here always need fixing. But at least no one's telling me what to fix.
If you need your ship repaired, find my associate. I break ours just by thinking about it.
It's all ancient history now, but the Earth lost its atmosphere. It started sputtering out into space. Humanity had about 50 years to evacuate the planet. That's kind of how the United Colonies government started, managing the exodus. Earth is more or less a dust bowl now. You can occasionally find a few remnants of the world we left behind on the surface, but not much. Keep your weapons ready. Never know who else might be scavenging there.
Docking siphon complete.
Two steps in, and we're already looking at a corpse. Okay, it's not Vanguard Moara.
Scavenging
around here, and someone else came in and said hello. This won't be your last encounter with the Spacer crew. They pillage abandoned facilities and shoot anyone who gets in their way. They're even less organized than the Crimson Fleet. Just countless desperate groups scavenging and killing to survive.
I had to reclaim some UC property, but this whole Star Yard is overrun. I fetched up my ship, and I'm heading to Neptune. Going to put in another request to get the fleet out here to deal with these spacers. But until then, if any of you thugs are listening, I'm the damn ghost stealing your stuff in the night. Clear out while you have the chance.
The word, and we'll get underway.
Captain.
My ship.
sure they had something we can use.
Am I glad to meet whoever you two are? Looks like we're all in one piece. Any day you walk away from, right? What? You guys still exist? Man, I've only heard stories.
We've heard stories, too. About a strange object you found on patrol.
So, you know what that thing is. I tried to hawk it in Sidonia, and the guy thought I was peddling phony titanium.
It doesn't play nice with scanners. It'd be worthless to someone trying to flip rare minerals quickly.
So you're saying I shouldn't be using it as a hood ornament? Hey, I'll trade some weird space rock for a rescue anytime. Hope you figure out whatever that thing is.
Let's grab the artifact.
Thanks again for the rescue. Don't know what I would have done if you hadn't jumped in.
Good work. Let's get back to the lodge. So, we eating at the Sage Brook, or is it just a quick snap from the Terra Brew?
Service, Captain.
We have it. Go ahead.
It fits. Energy spiked a bit, but it's restabilized.
Is there anything new showing up?
No, it's the same as before. There's a massive output as the artifact is added, then it harmonizes. Like it's waiting for the others.
That's speculation, but I think you're right. We need more. Here. You've earned this. Welcome to Constellation. As a full member this time. We're going to do great things together. All of us. By the way, how would you like to keep traveling together? I'm not sitting behind my desk for this. These artifacts are a new chapter for Constellation, and I'm going to be out there for it. And I want you out there as well. You got results. I need someone like you watching my back. All right. We've got a few more leads we should talk about. First, there's an expedition that Samco has been putting together. It's in Freestar Collective Space, and he knows it inside and out. There's also the Eye, our star station in orbit. About time for you to meet Vladimir. He's been hard at work tracking down more anomalies. And last but not least, Noelle. Have we heard anything from Barrett yet?
A courier from Argos Extractors came by to let us know they're packing up the operation on Vectera. But that's it, no other word.
That's not good. We should get over there and check on Barrett in person. Oh, that's right. He wasn't here when you first showed up. He should be back by now. I'll let him handle the introductions. If I steal his thunder, I'll never hear the end of it. His mind is always somewhere, but there's no arguing his knack for being in the right place at the wrong time. Oh, too bad he couldn't see the artifacts coming together. But knowing him, he'll be so excited when he gets a look, it won't occur to him that he's missed anything. We maintain a star station in orbit above us. It's where we do all our deep space scanning. Vladimir runs the station. Brilliant astronomer. Years of practical experience. It's all important, but if you want a direction, I'd grab Barrett first. He's not just an old friend. He's been all over the settled systems. You can thank Barrett for that, if he's still around to thank when this is all said and done. Honestly, he took this seriously before any of us. It was at his urging that we started doing deep space scans. I will admit, it was something of a shock to see Barrett taking anything seriously. Until later.
As much as I love uncovering new questions, I wouldn't mind a few answers now and then. I know everyone's excited by the artifacts, but we need to be as objective as possible and be aware of possible negative effects. Okay, let's take a look. Of course. There's plenty of planets out there that no one has ever set foot on, and everything we learn about them is valuable. We have a board where we post anything specific we're looking for. A type of alien flora or fauna, or a planet with a specific quality, like if it's primed to have life but doesn't yet. Oh, right, that. If we're approaching this rationally, I suppose we'd call them visual and auditory hallucinations. What you perceived as lights and music could be overloaded neural input, your brain's attempt to make sense of something, an energy surge, some other phenomenon. There might be a reasonable explanation. I wasn't there. I didn't see what you saw. I'm just not in a position to say for sure. That's okay. Now that this is, we're all in this together now. Stay safe, okay?
Feel free to help your-
Ask if you've got questions.
Second one was on Kazal, buried the same as the one you found. But the first one, right under our noses for years, sitting in storage, masquerading as an oversized paperweight. Can you imagine potentially the greatest discovery in human history collecting dust? Take care of yourself.
I cannot wait to meet him. It's been ages since Constellation has had someone new. I wonder what he's...
And you must be the latest poor fool to get dragged into our dysfunctional little family. Whoa. I know a few dark sides of the Aquila moons, but if you're looking for deep history lessons, well, I'm gonna fall asleep before you do.
Trust me. Don't encourage him. Kuriko, by the way. Hi, hi. Nice to meet anyone brave enough to fly the frontier.
Know a thing or two about spacecraft, do we?
Hey, don't spook our new friend. Frontier's a fine ship. Honest. Now, let's talk business. Sarah tell you about the expedition? Sure enough, that's where we're heading. The three of us are heading to Aquila, for a settled planet of the Freestar Collective and, not coincidentally, the home of their capital, Aquila City. We'll land in the city's spaceports, but the Frontier's our goal. It's rough country. Spawned a lot of stories. And I got a lead on... Okay. We'll meet you on board your ship. Talk more when we get there. Once we land on Aquila, it's gonna be you and me.
Welcome to MAST. If you have an appointment, you may proceed inside.
across most of the settled systems and all manners of spacecraft, and yet I still get sick on the gnat. So, where to next? Oh, hi, Sam.
Miss Morgan?
Sarah, please. Good work dealing with those merchants in Freestyle.
Bren? And...
What? I read your report. They sent thanks. Good job.
Good job? That's it?
Yes.
And we're on.
Aimpoint reached. Orbit stable.
Your hand scanner. I bet you'll find plenty here to catalogue.
Appreciate the lift. And once we touch down in Aquila, we'll talk more. Certainly. Here you go.
Dad and I will be riding passenger with you. The most boring. I want to fly my own ship and go all over the place. Like you and Dad, really. But hopefully not as crazy as your travels. I thought Dad's were exciting. But yours? Brr. I read. I look around the ship, but no touching. Dad lets me do all sorts of stuff on his ship. But he said I have to be respectful on your ship. But I could try to fix things if you ask. Hint, hint. You can ask. I promise I'll be good. It's the best. I met another kid my age who hadn't been on a starship once. Not even once. Same boring old planet for like years. She didn't even know how to replace a phase manifold. Can you imagine? Yup, I've been his co-pilot since I was old enough to read a map. He lets me fly sometimes, and fix things aboard, and use the intercom, and everything. I just have to promise not to complain about having to stay aboard the ship when we're somewhere dangerous. Dad says when I'm older, he'll teach me how to use a pistol, and once I'm a good enough shot, I can go with him anywhere. I can't wait to get older.